in this poster, we explored the cost effectiveness of risk stratified treatment for patients aged below 65 years, because those patients are transplant eligible. And in a previous study, it was found that patients with a low risk multiple myeloma, which means patients who have SCI 92 standard risk, ISS stage 1, and no DEL7TP, are better off if they receive bortezomib, melphalan, and prednisone instead of high dose melphalan followed by an autologous stem cell transplantation. The aim of our study was to not only assess the effectiveness in terms of survival, but also identify whether the specific treatment regime is more cost effective. Because in order to identify whether the patients belong to the low risk group, patients need an additional diagnostic test needs to be performed, which is associated with higher costs. In our study, we identified the cost of the different treatment options and compared that with the survival outcome and quality of life outcome. And we found the low-risk patients indeed have a better survival outcome, also combined with the quality of life estimate. But the total treatment costs are also higher if they are treated with bortezomib, melphalan, and prednisone. The main reason for the higher cost is because patients live longer, and in the additional life years, they have additional treatment costs due to continuous maintenance treatment costs. However, the costs per life year gained are acceptable, and therefore it seems to be a good option, both from a medical perspective as well from a health reimbursement perspective, to consider to treat patients with low risk in the low risk group differently than patients treated otherwise. It was not specifically explored. In the current analysis, we assumed that the quality of life did not differ for patients who received either melphalan, bortezomib, and prednisone, or high-dose melphalan followed by autologous stem cell transplantation. But we will, in the next step of the study, we will dive into our research regarding the quality of life study to identify whether there are some reasons to assume that the quality of life does differ between the treatment options.